Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is static data members. It is a very important topic in C++ programming concepts, and the static data members, I will just give a brief overview of the static data members in this video. After that, I will go on to show you a program which helps us to implement the concept of the static data members in C++ programming. So, what is static members? A static member variable has certain special characteristics. You can just note it down. A static member variable has certain special characteristics, and these characteristics can be given point-wise. And suppose the number one characteristic can be, a static data member is always initialized to zero when the first object of its class is created. Number two point is, only one copy of that member is created for the entire class and is shared by all the objects of that class, no matter how many objects are created. Number three point is, a static data member is visible only within the class. A static data member is visible only within the class, but its lifetime is the entire program. A static data member is visible only within the class, but its lifetime is the entire program. So now suppose we are going to show you an example program or an illustrative program to demonstrate the use of static data members. So let me just explain the program in detail to you. First is the hash include iostream, that is the file inclusion directive. After that, using namespace std, then we go on to declare a class, that is class abc, under which we take, under the private visibility modifier, because nothing has been declared explicitly above this these two data members, so it will be by default taken as private data members. And under the private visibility modifier, we see that there are two data members, out of which this is a data member which is an ordinary data member, and this one is a static data member. So this int c and this static int count, these two have differences between them. Int c is an ordinary data member or a member variable, ordinary member variable, and this cnt, this int cnt is preceded by a keyword static, which means that this cnt variable is a static data member. And this static data member is the topic of discussion in this video. Now see what I have tried to show you in this program. Under the public section, I have defined two member functions, that is void get underscore data, supplied a value, supplied an actual argument int, supplied a formal argument rather. Int a is the formal argument, and under that only a single expression statement has been given, as c is equal to a. There is another statement is also following this c is equal to a, that is cnt plus plus. So I have written, what is this? I have assigned the value of this a that is given as the formal argument, that is some integer value will be given in the parenthesis as actual argument when the program is being in the main section of the program, and that value, that integer value, will be stored or assigned into this member variable c by this expression statement c is equal to a. And after that, I have also written another expression statement cnt plus plus, that is this static data member is being incremented by unity in this second expression statement of this void get data function. After that, another function is being written as void get underscore cnt, and in that I have only written one single expression statement by which we have printed the value of cnt by this statement cout new line CNT is equal to CNT end L. After that, we come to the end of this class declaration. Now we come, before going to the main section, there is one thing to be noted. One thing to be noted, that is, we have to write every static member which has been declared, static data member which has been declared in a particular class, by writing this sort of statement. Suppose we have taken this CNT, if we have, we could have taken another static member here also. So in that case, for each static data member in a class, before moving on to the main section, we need to write this sort of statement, that is, what is the data type of that static data member, followed by the class name in which it is being declared, followed by a scope resolution operator, followed by the identifier which has been given for the static data member. In this case, I have only one static data member in CNT, that's why I've written int ABC. That is, the class name is ABC, data type is int, scope resolution operator CNT, that is the name of the static data member. You can see that the static data member is CNT, which has been declared beforehand. This is that static data member, static int CNT. After that, we move on to the main section. What we do over here is create three objects one by one. And what is the speciality, what is one of the speciality of static data members is that when you go on to create the first instance of a class, when you go on to create the first instance of any class of which the static data member is a member, then for the first instance creation, that is the first object creation, the value of the static data member will be initialized to zero, and that will be accessible by all the objects in a shared manner. So this ABC A comma B comma C means we have created three objects of the class ABC, and when you create this first object or the first instance of the class ABC, then only the static data member CNT gets the value of 0 by the very property of the static data member. Now suppose the CNT value is 0. Now we see that after that we have written three expression statements quite similar to each other, in which we have invoked the get underscore CNT member function with the help of the object A in the first statement, in the first set of statement, first statement of the set of the statements. Now we come to the int main section, and in the int main section we create three objects A, B, C of this class ABC. And the interesting thing is that when you create the first instance or the first object of any class of which a static data member is a member of, by the first creation, first instance creation or the first object creation, the default value of the static data member is set to 0 by the very property of a static data member. So when we declare, when we create this object A, in that situation the value of the static data member CNT is being assigned to 0. After that, I have written three statements quite similar to each other. One as A dot get CNT, get underscore CNT. Next is B dot get underscore CNT, C dot get underscore CNT. So we invoke the get underscore CNT function with the help of the object small a in the first line, in second line by small b object, and in the next statement by means of the object small c. We write this statement, that is a dot get data within parenthesis, actual argument is given as 10. Suppose you can give any other value for this, in this case, in this example, You can put your own values to see if that works, that they will also work as well. So this a.getData within parenthesis 10 means we are supplying an actual argument of 10, that is, we are supplying a value, integer value, which has been defined here. Let's go to this function definition, get underscore data int a. So what is this formal argument? That value 10, which has been given as the actual argument when we go on to invoke or call the function get underscore data by the help of the object small a, lowercase a, then this actual argument will be automatically, the value of the actual argument, that is 10, will be automatically copied into the formal argument a, int a, and that value will be passed on or assigned to the ordinary data member, which has been declared under the protected under the private section of the class ABC, that is C. So C will acquire a value supplied in the function call. So in the first case, 10 will be given as the actual argument. In the second statement, I have written b.getData given a value of 20. Then c.getData given a value of 30. So in these three statements, we see that the variable, the member variable c of object lowercase a will be assigned a value of 10. Member variable c of the object b will be assigned a value of 20. Member variable c of object lowercase c will be assigned a value of, see what we have written, assigned a value of 30. After that, again we invoke the get underscore cnt function in a manner as was written above in these three lines. So suppose we have repeated these three lines after the three get data functions, that is a dot get underscore cnt, b dot get underscore cnt, c dot get underscore cnt. So what will be the output over here? Suppose when we create this object a, the static data member cnt gets the value of 0. So now we see this a dot get cnt, a, the object a, will see the value of cnt to be 0, object b will also see the value of cnt to be 0, and object c will also see the value of that cnt variable, which is a static data member variable, static data member, as 0 as well, because the static data members, as has already been discussed, is being shared by all the objects of a class in which the static data member has been declared. So all of these objects a, b and c sees the value of cnt to be 0. Now when we call this function a dot gets underscore cnt, let me see what I have written above. Get underscore cnt is written above, no, written below rather. So c out n cnt is equal to cnt. So what is this? C out n cnt new line, that is the new line n backslash n cnt is equal to space cnt, that is the count will be displayed as 0 because cnt value is 0 now. B dot get cnt again prints 0 because b also sees the value of cnt to be 0. Since c also sees the same value, that is 0 for cnt, the c dot get count will also display the cnt value as cnt is equal to 0. So we get some sort of output as we are expecting to get, rather some sort of output as cnt is equal to 0, cnt is equal to 0, cnt is equal to 0 in the first three lines of the output. After that, we see that we have invoked the data member function get underscore data with once with 10 and then with 20 and after that with 30. So when we call this, suppose a dot get data underscore get underscore data with the actual argument 10, the control passes to this portion, this function definition, this void get data int a, so a becomes 10. 10 is assigned to the C member variable. After that, we see that there is an increment of the static data member by unity, that is CNT plus plus, in which we can easily say or infer that the value of the static data member CNT is being incremented from 0 to 1. So after this, again after calling the function a b dot get data underscore 20, again this 20 will be assigned to the variable c of object b, and the static data member is shared by all the objects, and then the b object, the object b, will increment this cnt by unity once again, so that the CNT value will become 2 now. After that, in a similar way, when we call the function c dot get data with 30 as the actual argument, then again the value of CNT becomes 3 from 2 by being incremented by unity, and the value 30 goes to the data member c under the object C. And after that, we again invoke the get underscore CNT function thrice, once with A, then with B, and then with C, like this: A dot get underscore CNT, B dot get underscore CNT, C dot get underscore CNT. So in this case, when we see the output of this CNT, we will see definitely that since the CNT has been incremented to 3 after the execution of the third statement of this set of three statements of where the get data function is being called, so the CNT value has become 3 in this statement. The cursor is blinking beside the statement which has incremented the static data member CNT by unity to become 3. So now all the objects A, B, and C are seeing a common value, seeing the shared value 3 of the static data member CNT. So if we go on to print the value or go on to display the value of CNT by this get underscore CNT function from A or B or C, irrespective of whichever object we use with this function call, in all the cases we expect that the value will be 3. So what should be the expected output for the first three lines? It will be CNT is equal to 0, CNT is equal to 0, CNT is equal to 0. Now it will come like this: CNT is equal to 3, CNT is equal to 3, CNT is equal to 3. So let's see whether the program gives an output which we have expected. So go to this build and run and click it once. We see that a window opens, the output window opens, and we see that CNT is equal to 0, CNT is equal to 0, CNT is equal to 0, then CNT is equal to 3, CNT is equal to 3, CNT is equal to 3, quite exactly in the same manner it has given the output as we have expected to give the output from the program. So we see that the program runs correctly and the desired output is also being achieved by us, and in this way we have shown you how the static data members are implemented in the object-oriented programming with C++. So press any key to continue. suppose I press the space key and we come to the end of this explanation. So friends, if you have any doubts and queries pertaining to this entire explanation, you can well post your doubts and queries into the comment section below so that I can address them.